Students, once again, very good morning to all of you. Students, today we are going to read our chapter number 2 of course book, that is My Early Home, written by Anna Sewell. My Early Home, students, this is a autobiography of a horse. In this chapter, a horse has told the story of his childhood. Okay, before reading the chapter, let's understand few word meanings. Listen very carefully. First is meadow. Meadow means field or grass field area. The area filled with grass where animals came for grazing. They eat grass in that area. Okay, meadow means field or grass field area means the area filled with grass where animals graze. They eat grass. Next, rushes means tall grass-like plants that grow near water. Rushes means tall grass-like plants which are grown near the water. Near pond, near streams, okay. Next, hedge. A line of bushes or small trees planted very close together. Hedge is a line of bushes or you can say line of small trees planted very close to each other. Rudra, what are you doing? Especially along the edge of a field. These hedges we can found near the edge of a field. Edge means a bank or you can say border. Okay. Next, plantation. Plantation is a large farm, a very big farm, a very big area where a particular type of crop is grown, where the same type of crop is grown. In a very large area. That is called plantation. Next, brook. Brook is a small narrow stream. Small river you can see. Colts, young male horses. Next, gallop. Run fast. This word is used for horses. Frequently, regularly, repeatedly. Next. Whinnied. Past tense of whinnied. This is a soft, high sound. Very high sound made by a horse. A soft, high sound, loud sound made by a horse. That is called whinnied. Next is temper. That is a state of mind. It may be angry state or happy. Okay. State of mind. Next, will. Here, will means ability, capability and interest. Trot. Run slowly. Run very slowly. That is called trot. Lodging. Lodging is a place to stay where one can stay. Okay. Neigh. Make a long, loud, high call. The sound of a horse, you can say. Okay. This word is used for sound of a horse. Stroke. Rub gently. Gently or kindly. Gig. Here gig means two-wheeled carriage drawn by one horse. Two-wheeled carriage or you can say cart which is drawn by one horse. Next, plowboy. A boy who guides a horse when it plows a field. Guide means lead, a boy who leads a horse when it plow, or you can say while plowing or while farming a field. A boy who lead a horse while farming a field. That boy is called plow boy. In a snap, very quickly, very fast, box a blow with the fist. Position of hand, your position of hand by closing fingers. When you hit someone by closing your fingers, that is box. Roar, make a long, loud, deep sound. Mostly we use this word for the sound of lion. Lion roared. Okay, make a long, loud, deep sound. Well off. Here, well off means comfortable, relaxation. Okay. Yes, dear students. Now, look at the warm-up box. Solve this crossword using the clues. Clues are given. First one is a female horse is called. A female horse is called. We are doing this one. Mare. M-A-R-E. Second, a young male horse is called. We have done this in the word meaning also. Colt. C-O-L-T. Colt. Okay, female horse is called mare and young male horse is called colt. Third, a young female horse, a young female horse is called filly, F-I-L-L-Y. Next one, a small horse is called a pony. P-O-N-Y. When a horse runs fast, that is gallop, G-A-L-L-O-P. And the last one, when a horse runs slow, it trots, T-R-O-T-S. We have done this in word meaning. Meaning of trot, run slowly. Okay, again I am repeating. A female horse is called a mare. A young male horse is called a colt. A young female horse is called filly. A small horse is called a pony. When a horse runs fast, it gallops, and when a horse runs slow, it trots. Okay. Yes, dear students, this is the story, My Early Home. This is the part of a novel, Black Beauty. Yashvi. Okay. This story is a part of a famous novel, Black Beauty, written by Anna Sewell. The narrator, who is the narrator? Who is telling the story? The narrator here is a handsome black horse named Black Beauty. Means here, a horse is telling his story and his name is Black Beauty. He spends his early childhood in a pleasant meadow. Where he has spent his childhood? In pleasant meadow. Meadow means grassy area. Where he is treated with kindness. Where he is treated by his master, by his owner, very politely. Then he is sold. Then he was sold and he has many different masters, many different owners. Some masters were kind, some masters were cruel, some masters were foolish. The story brings out that, what is the story tells us that, how animals like human beings have feelings and that they ought to be treated with love and affection. The story tells us that animals also have feelings like human beings. That's why animals should be treated treated with love and affection. Okay? We should treat them kindly. We should never hurt them because they also have feelings like us. Yes, dear students, let's start reading. The first place that I can remember well is a large, pleasant meadow with a pond of clear water in it. Who is telling the story? A young colt, Black Beauty. Okay, a horse is telling the story. The first place that I can remember well. A horse is telling that the first place that is in his mind even now is a large, pleasant meadow. It's a very big area of grass that gives him happiness. Pleasant means happiness. And this area was near the pond. Pond means small water body. Okay. That area was, that pleasant meadow was near the pond of clear water. Okay. The first place that the horse remembered even now, that is the large, very big pleasant meadow with a pond of. There was a pond of clear water in that meadow. Okay, there was a very small water body in that meadow. Meadow means in that grassy area. That place is remembered by the colt. Some shady trees leaned over it. There was there were some shady trees, the trees that gave shade. The trees that give shade, they are shady trees. There were some shady trees near the pond. And rushes. Rushes means tall grass-like plants. And there were some grass-like plants. And water lilies grew at the deep end. There were some grass-like plants and water lilies were also there. At the deep end, you can say at the edge or at the bank of that pond. Okay. The horse is talking about the place where he spent his childhood. That was a large, very big, pleasant meadow, grassy area with a pond of clear water in it. Okay. There were some shady trees over it and some grass-like plants and water lilies were also there. Over the hedge on one side, over the bushes, over the line of bushes, on one side we looked into a plowed field. On one side, Mayank Rathi, what are you doing? Over the hedge on one side, if we looked over the hedge, over the bushes, on the one side, there was a plowed field. There was a farming field. And on the other side, we looked over a gate at our master's house, means over the hedge, over the bushes, there was a plowed field on one side, there was a field on one side and on the other side, there was a gate at our master's house. There was a gate of our master's house. Master means the owner of that horse, which stood by the roadside. That house was by the, that house was located by the roadside. At the top of the meadow was a plantation of fir trees. At the top of this meadow, that grassy area, there was a plantation. Plantation means a large farm where a particular type of crop is grown. Okay. On the top of that meadow, there was a large farm where fir trees were grown. Only fir trees were grown there. And at the bottom of that meadow, there was a stream. Brook means stream, with steep banks, slanting banks or slanting borders, you can say, slanting edge, you can see. Okay. Again, I am repeating. On the hedge, over the hedge means lines of bushes. Over the hedge, we can, the horse could look at the plowing field on the one side, and he could look at the master's gate on the other side, which was stood by the house was stood by the roadside. And at the top of the meadow, at the top of the grassy area, there was a large farm where fir trees were grown. And at the bottom of that meadow, that grassy area, there was a small stream. Next, while I was young, I drank my mother's milk as I could not eat grass. Horse was telling us about his childhood, that when he was so young, when Black Beauty was so young, when that colt was so young, he drank his mother's milk because he could not eat grass. In the daytime, I ran by her side. During the daytime, the horse ran by her mother's side. He always stayed with her mother. And at night, I lay down close by her. And during night, he always lay with her close by his mother, because he was too young at that time. When it was hot, we used to stand, we means colt and his mother. You can see in the picture also. This is the colt and this is his mother. This is the story that we are reading. That is the story of a colt. Okay. He is telling the story about his childhood. Yes, when it was hot, we used to stand by the pond in the shade of the trees. During that day, when it was very hot, the colt and his mother, they stood by the pond near the water body. They stood in the shade of the trees. The trees were near the pond. And it was cold. When it was cold, we had a nice warm shed near the plantation. When it was hot, they stood near the pond under the shady trees. And when it was cold, they had a nice warm shed. They stayed in a nice warm shed near the plantation, near the area of fir trees. Okay. As soon as I was old enough to eat grass, when the colt was grown, when he became old, he could then eat grass. Then my mother used to go out to work in the daytime. When he grown old, then his mother, he usually went out to work in the daytime. During the daytime, his mother went out for work and came back in the evening. There were six young colts in the meadow beside me. There were six another young colts also. Colts means male horses also in that meadow. They were older than I was, and the six colts were older than Black Beauty. Some were nearly as large grown-up horses. Some of the six young colts, they were grown grown up horse. They look like grown up horses. I used to run with them and had great fun. The black beauty and the six colts, they run and they had great fun. We used to gallop together. All of them used to run fast. They do the activities together, round and round the field. They gallop, they run fast, round and round the field, round and round the meadow, as hard as we could do. As hard as we could do means they did the same activity until they tired. Okay, they gallop around the field. They did this activity until they were tired. Sometimes we had rather rough play, for they would frequently bite and kick. But sometimes they play rough games that were not good. The games that were not good. For they would frequently bite and kick. What were these rough games? They repeatedly bite, they often bite and kick each other. That's a rough game. One day, when there was a good deal of kicking, my mother went to me to come to her. And then she said, when they were doing the same activity, when they were kicking to each other, his mother whinnied. Whinnied means a high sound made by a horse. His mother called him and then she said, I wish you to pay attention to what I am going to say to you. His mother said, I want that you should listen very carefully what I am saying to you. The colts who live here are good colts. What did the mother say? The colts who are living here means she was talking about the six young colts. The colts who are living here, they are good colts, but they are cart horse colts. But they are used for pulling carts. They are used for pulling carriage. And of course, they have not learned manners. And they have not learned any manners. They all are mannerless. They have no manners. You have been well bred. Mother said that. Mother said to the Black Beauty that you have been well bred and well born. Mother said that you have good manners. You are well born. Your father has a great name in these parts. Mother was saying that your father has a great name. He was a very good horse. He was very famous for his kindness in these parts, means in this area. And your grandfather won the cup 2 years back at the New Market race. And your grandfather won a cup in the race, New Market race. And what about your grandmother? Your grandmother had the sweetest temper of any horse I ever knew. And your grandmother, she had the sweetest temper. She was very sweet horse. I have never seen a horse like her. And I think you have never seen me kick or bite. And mother was saying that I think you have never seen me also. I never kick any horse. I never bite any horse. I hope you will grow up gentle and good. Now I hope you will also grow gentle. You will also learn good manners. Do your and never learn bad ways. That means she was trying to taught the young colt that never hurt anyone. Learn good manners, never learn bad manners. Do your work with a good will. Do your work with interest. Lift your feet up well when you trot. When you walk, lift your feet very well. That means walk properly. Never kick anyone. Arav, what are you doing? And never bite or kick even the play. Even while playing, never kick anyone. Never bite anyone. Okay? That was the advice of a mother to her child, to her young colt. I have never forgotten my mother's advice. Now, the Black Beauty said that he had never forgotten his mother's advice. I knew she was very wise. She was very intelligent. Black Beauty is saying that I knew that his mother was very wise, intelligent, and our master thought a great deal to her. Our master, our owner also respected her, gave respect to her. Her name was Duchess. And what was the name of Black Beauty's mother? Duchess. But he often called her pet. But the master often called her pet. Our master was a good, kind man. Who was a kind man? Their master, their owner, owner of Duchess and Black Beauty. He was a kind man. He gave us good food, good lodging, and kind words. He always gave us good food to eat, good lodging, means good place to stay, and always spoke kind words. Always spoke with them kindly, politely. He spoke as kindly to us as he did to his little children. The owner of the horses, he always spoke to them gently as he spoke to her, to his children. We were all fond of him. We all liked him. All the horses liked the master because he was very kind. And my mother loved him very much. Who loved him very much? Colt's mother, Duchess. When she saw him at the gate, she would neigh with joy. When his mother, Duchess, saw the owner, saw the master at the gate, she would neigh. She would make a sound with happiness and trot up to him. And she slowly went to him at the gate. He would pat and stroke her and say, the master patted her back gently. And what he said, well, old pet, and how is your little darky? Good, old pet. And how is your darky? Your little darky. Darky is the name of the colt. Okay. Given by the master. What was the name given to the mother by the master? Pet. And what was the name given to the colt given by the master? Darky. I was a dull black. So he called me darky because of his dark black color. The master called him darky. You can see in the picture. He is dull black in color. That's why master called him darky. Then he would give me a piece of bread, which was very good. And sometimes he brought a carrot for my mother. What did master give to them? A piece of bread, which was very good in taste. And sometimes he brought a carrot for his mother, Duchess. She would eat hers with relish. The carrot was very tasty. She ate that delicious carrot All the horses would come to him, but I think we were his favorite. Colt is saying that all the horses liked him, liked the master. They came to him, but we think that we both were his favorites. My mother always took him to the town on a market day in a light gig. Gig is a cart. Always, who took him to the owner to the market? His mother, Duchess. There was a plowboy, Saksham. There was a plowboy, Dick, who sometimes came into our field to pluck blackberries from the hedge. There was a plowboy who guides a horse while farming or while plowing a field. His name was Dick, who sometimes came in the field to pluck, to take blackberries from the hedge, from the bushes or from the small trees, small plants. When he had eaten all he wanted, he would have what he called fun with the colts. When he ate the blackberries, then he made a fun of colts by throwing stones and sticks at them to make them gallop. He threw stones and sticks at the horses so that they gallop. They run fast. We did not mind him much. They ignored him. They did not feel bad. For we could gallop off because they could gallop. They could run fast. But sometimes a stone would hit and hurt us. But sometimes a stone or a stick, they hurt them. Mayank, rub this. Yes, one day he was at this game and did not know that the master was in the next field. Again, one day, Dick was doing the same activity, the same thing. That means he was throwing sticks and stones at the horses. He didn't know that the master, the owner, was in the next field. But the owner was there watching what was going on. He was observing that what was going on in the field, that Dick was throwing the stones and sticks at the horses. Over the hedge, over the bushes, he jumped in a snap and catching Dick by the arm. When he observed all the things, he jumped over the hedge, over the bushes, and caught Dick by the arm. He gave him such a box. He gave him, you can say, a slap on the ear as made him roar with pain and surprise.